Strictly speaking, financial crimes do not kill people. They kill dreams, they kill hopes, and they kill confidence in long-term saving and investing. Here is my updated list of the 10 biggest investment scams in the Philippines. Number 10, Bancap scam. Known losses, 900 million pesos. This was a treasury bill scam run by Marilyn Nite. Number 9, Franc Suisse and Deutsche Francs. Known losses, 1 billion pesos. These were classic high-yielding investment products marketed through the internet from March to July 2007 that offered as much as 4.5% returns per day. Some of the victims included politicians and celebrities. It folded after a media report in the Philippine Daily Inquirer caused investors to withdraw their money and the pyramid collapsed. The National Bureau of Investigation caught Eleazar Castillo, chief financial advisor of Franc Suisse, and filed syndicated estafa charges against him. Number 8. Swiss Mutual Fund International Scam. Losses unknown. This was an international online scheme that had been running for more than a decade before it hit the Philippines, offering high guaranteed returns. Number 7. Royal Manchester 5 Trading Corporation. Known losses, 2 billion pesos. This was a currency trading program that promised a 4% per month guaranteed return to investors in 2008. The government filed charges against Cyrus Howe after receiving complaints from investors who weren't able to get their money back. Number 6. Tibayan Group Investment Corporation. Known losses, 2 billion pesos. In 2003, this mutual fund scheme guaranteed 3-5.5% interest a month for a 6-month to 1-year lock-in period. The SEC filed charges of falsification of documents and violation of the Securities Regulation Code against Tibayan. It said the company used numerous front corporations and partnerships to solicit investments from the public. Number 5. Mateo Management Group. Known losses, 4.3 billion pesos. In 2003, couple Irvin and Evelyn Mateo enticed at least 20 people to invest billions of pesos by promising high guaranteed returns. They disappeared after getting the investment. The government filed 30 counts of a syndicated estafa against both, as well as 5 other officers of the group. Number 4. Performance Investment Products Corporation. Known losses, 11 billion pesos in today's exchange rate. In 2007, an alleged forex trading outfit duped people who were blinded by the 10-15% guaranteed return being offered. This was a scam that victimized mostly rich people. Some got in, thinking too many important and smart people can't be wrong. Evidently, they were. The mastermind, Singaporean Michael Liu, allegedly absconded and gave up some $138 million to be given back to his investors. However, Liu is still at large and is also facing cases in Hong Kong. Number 3. Aman Futures Group. Known losses, 12 billion pesos. In 2012, over 100,000 families in Pagadian City were enticed in commodities trading investments that offered up to 80% profit in 20 days. A manhunt is still ongoing for founder Manuel Amalillo. Number 2. Multinational Telecom Investors Corporation. Known losses, 25 billion pesos. In 2002, more than 950,000 individuals got burned in this investment scheme that offered 4%-5% a month. Queen Mastermind Rosario Balajay is still in jail. Number 1. Legacy Group. Known losses, 30 billion pesos. In 2008, Celso de Los Angeles Group of Companies offered motorcycle loan and investment loan programs with guaranteed commissions of up to 15,000 pesos. Angeles was put in jail and died of cancer in 2012. All these scams depended on fresh victims, charisma of leaders, greed among investors, and curiously, misplaced trust. For Ponzi schemes to continue, all the leaders need is more investors signing up than those who are closing accounts. Here's a sinister trend going on at the moment. Filipinos are no longer afraid to put money in companies that have been identified by the government as scams. In other words, they know these are not good for the people they recruit, but they don't care. Greed has either made them blind or willing partners to the crime. This is true with the two latest cash scams, MGoldex and its Philippine counterpart GoldExtreme, and One Lightning Corporation. The SEC has recently issued another advisory against HPI Direct Sales, warning investors to stay away from unregistered securities. SEC Chairperson Teresita Herbosa said if these companies do not cease operations as ordered, the government will physically close down their offices.
Once we post an advisory, you can be sure that we will be investigating further that company, because that's only a preliminary step. And once we issue a cease and desist order, we're not supposed to engage in the business anymore. So what we do is we're going to now physically close the office. Because before, we'd like to just believe that people will cease going to those offices where the investment scam is going on. But it seems that they don't believe us. And I think we'll just have to go and physically show to people that we'll have to close the office.
Everything that we do catches up with us. I truly believe that. So stay away from scams. If you have any questions, email me at anc.onthemoney@gmail.com. Message me on our Facebook pages, ANC On The Money and SalveDuplito.onthemoney, or tweet me with hashtag SalveSays.